That's me, and that's where I was on the night of August 4, 2004, doing exactly that. It was after the second song. Everything was going along fine. The day had been totally normal. All of a sudden, all these crazy things started happening in my head. I started seeing lights and colors, and the music that I was playing sounded incredibly distant and far away. And then I just threw my guitar off. I ran off the stage. I remember being put in the ambulance, and that's exactly the last thing I remember for about a year and a half.
The attending neurosurgeon said to us that Jason's chances for survival were slim, and that if he did survive, his neurological prognosis was very poor.
Okay. Now I want you to grab a yellow one. Grab the yellow one on the far right. The yellow one on the right.
Ready?
Here's the left, and then here's the right. Can you grab the yellow one on the right? Alright, how about just grab a yellow one?
Without any consultation with each other, my family and I always believed that Jason would make it. Even as Jason descended into this minimally responsive, or a lot of the time non-responsive state, he still floated up to the surface occasionally, and one of us was always with him to catch these moments. Now watch Jason's mouth closely in this next clip. When Margaret asks Jason if he's a musician, he smiles briefly.
Are you a musician?
He said, "I love you." We hugged Jason, we kissed him, we held his hand, you know, just to feel someone's hand in your hand. We visualized Jason healthy and walking and playing the guitar. And we encouraged him to visualize himself doing those things also. We kept our minds open to all possibilities. A year and a week after Jason's initial hemorrhage, he came home. The doctors here said to us, "Do you know what you're getting into? This is 24 hours a day." And we honestly, we didn't know what we were getting into, I think. But we did it anyway.
I think when you're in a situation where you've suffered an injury like this, you need to have all the resources available that you can to pull yourself out of this. I could only really focus on what was happening in the present moment. You know, my short-term memory was totally gone. I started to have more awareness of what had happened. And along with this came an increase of depression and sadness.
One, two, three. Stand up.
I would tend to get down and get sad or depressed or something, and then after a little bit of time of being there in that state, it would transform and morph into a kind of determination. You know, I would get really fired up to recover as much as I possibly could, and I would work even harder, or I would, you know, dig into my exercises even more, or do whatever I had to do to get myself to the next point. And I'd still like that. I still have the exercises I do every day, and things that I have to work on.
We're here to basically show what's possible. You know, in the face of a seemingly impossible situation, we want to show, you know, what can be done. When you look back on a situation like this, how do you want to remember your role in it? How do you want to think of yourself as having dealt with something like this?